Hi YouTube, it's KFH 2020 with another video, and I have got another guitar. This one is a beautiful piece. It is a Fender Sonoran, which is the three-quarter sized version of my Newporter, which I have, and that was my first guitar and I love it to bits. So when I saw this opportunity to get a Sonoran, which is a little mini version of my guitar, I was super excited. So basically I'm going to try something different today. I'm just going to take you through this video real time, and I'll speed up parts that aren't working and maybe even play a bit of music over the top of them. We'll see. I'm just having fun with this channel. So I'm going to give this a full clean up and set up, and first thing to do will be detension all the strings and cut them off. So always detune all the strings before cutting them off, otherwise you can cause some big problems with the neck getting stressed the wrong way. Okay, so we've cut all the strings off. Time to do the fiddly bit of getting them all out. Make sure you keep them all in the pile, otherwise they have a nasty habit of jamming in your fingers. Them all off at the headstock end. Just try and keep them all nice and neat and bunch them together if you want. Just like that. Just try and hold them together a bit easier. You can set them on the floor and they have less of a chance of impaling your foot. So next step is to try and get the bridge pins out. Now on something like a Fender, mass-produced item, it should probably be fine whichever way the bridge pins go in, but my number one rule is, doesn't matter if it's mass-produced or not, always just have a go at keeping things in the same place they were when you got them, because if they worked when you got them and you put them back, they should work again. So I'll be keeping a note of where each one of these bridge pins goes, and I'll line them up behind me and we'll be good. And it's the rest of the string, so I'll do that with the rest. This tool, by the way, is a multi-tool, and you can use it to wind the strings, you can use it to cut the strings, and you can use it to pull the bridge pins, and it is fantastic. It costs about £10. So just get yourself one of them. Nice fit and finish actually. I've had a look online, so this is the guitar now totally de-stringed. I had a look online and this bridge with these little pearl inlays at the corners are quite a new, like an old thing actually. I don't see the new models, they've got a totally different shaped bridge, so I don't know how old this three-quarter Sonoran is, but I believe it's got a solid maple top and mahogany back and sides with a mahogany neck and a rosewood fingerboard. And I'm just having a look at it now. I mean, it's beautiful. The previous owner did mention it had these chips on the lacquer. That's not something I care about. I'm not going to even try and do anything with that. But it's just really nice to see one of these guitars with a natural finish, and all the binding looks really good. There's a bit of wood dust in there that was probably there from the manufacturer, so we'll get a bit of paper towel in there and just clean it. And we're going to polish the outside of the guitar and all its associated pieces. So that's what we're going to do first. So, first things first, just going to put a bit of this on. I'm just going to go around and get all the big bits of dust off, because there's no point putting polish on if it's still filthy. So that's all the kind of grot off of it. We can start polishing. I mean, this really doesn't need a lot done to it. I'm going to get a screwdriver.
Got a screwdriver.
So I'll fix this while I'm thinking about it. Of course, it's the wrong size screwdriver. Welcome to any time you need a screwdriver. A much more appropriately sized screwdriver. Snip that down. That's much better. Oh, and it's got a pin one at the back. I didn't realise that. So that's a tapered pin that's pushed in. So that's fine. That doesn't need anything done. Okay then. So, bit of a rag. A bit of wood polish. I use this pledge wood. Well, I would if there was much left. There's a small bit left. And just off we go. Can see the grot that's coming off of it, and the wonderful shine we're starting to get on this guitar. I mean, credit to the previous owner, it was already very shiny. I love working on guitars. If I had like a dream job, I'd probably be working on a guitar. I'm going to go get some more polish because that stuff is out. Okay, I'm back, and I've got some enhancing polish, which honestly should not be any different. That's a slightly different smell. It's all polish. Just work it along. Polishing as we go. Just a teeny weeny bit. That's really all you need. And then it gets so smooth. I mean, it feels like sheet glass, which is awesome. Just absolutely awesome. I'm a total nerd for working on these things, just as much as I am for playing them. I started playing during lockdown, and it's just been a love ever since. Thank you. find the problem is if you make something too perfect, well then you never bloody use it again. Right, where's my screwdriver? The screws do seem to tighten back down. I'm not too worried about them, but of course if there was ever a problem in the future, it's a simple enough job to simple enough job to just take a toothpick, fill the hole, and fill it. And then you can drill a new hole, and you're all good. So, I'm happy with this. We have one beautifully shiny guitar. Oh, I haven't done the headstock. Around the nut. Okay, so fantastic. Good, good. So the next step is going to be to polish the frets. And the reason we're going to polish the frets before we oil the fingerboard is basically I don't want to get any kind of muck on the fingerboard once it's been oiled. I don't really think this needs oiled. It's a little dry, so it'll get oiled. And I'll oil the bridge, as they're the two main parts of the guitar that are exposed when... It's basically so you oil them. So I'm going to need my tools. So these are my little fret covers, and they go on here. Now I can polish a fret without getting any muck on it. So for that, I'm going to reuse this bit of tissue because it's going to get very black. Brasso always does. I'm going to bundle it up into a little wad like that. I'm going to get my tin of Brasso. Stuff, honestly, the lid is just a push fit, but it's a nightmare. I'm going to dab it in, soak it all up. It's a heck of a smell from Brasso as well. Put my guide over it, and then just go back and forth. And as if by magic, all the marks are going to go away. Now, I'm lucky because this guitar has had little use. So it's not even really like it's worn very much at all. Gonna make sure I've not missed anything, and I haven't. Looks alright. Yep. Good. Right. So, clean the extra residue off of this. These are great. These are just teeny bits of sheet metal. And they cost barely anything. Stop you messing up your fretboard. And now I'll polish. you can see that the frets are looking much better, nice and shiny. Don't know if it shows up. You might just have to take my word for it. And the final thing to do is go with our polishing cloth, the side we weren't using for the polish, and just go over there. Just to make sure we've got all the brass off. Turn it over. And do it again. Perfect. Okay. Just making sure it's still recording. Incredibly paranoid that a long video means it's just going to stop at some point. You can't really go back. So, okay, I've pretty much used this cloth, so we're done with that. These are just microfiber cloths, same ones you use for your glasses. I'm going to get some scissors. I'm going to cut two little squares off. This is a very exciting project, because not only do I love acoustics, I think I lean more to acoustics than electrics. Although I have electrics, and I do very much enjoy playing them. It's just so cool to have a mini version of my guitar, as I have said many a time. So, we'll tighten those screws. Tighten this one on the string tree. I don't know if this guitar went through a lot of vibrations or something, but some of the screws are a bit loose, but fortunately that is a very easy fix. So. Okay, it's looking good. Very good. Right, so, time to apply this. This is Dunlop 65 lemon oil. It's just the stuff that I got told to use, and I use it, and it works. So, what you want to do is just put a little squirt on the fretboard. Get your applying rag and just work it in. And it's a wonderful process, because you work it in and all of a sudden this wonderful wood colour starts appearing out of the... And this will be proper rosewood. I got a Tanglewood guitar before I got this to be a travel guitar, and it's absolutely beautiful. It sounds amazing, but it doesn't have a rosewood, it's got like this teak wood one, and I really don't mind, but there is something very nice about rosewood. And I'm also going to apply a little bit on the bridge. So that's soaking in nicely, so we'll leave that for a minute, and while we're doing that, I'm going to go in a sound hole and clean some of this wood dust that I was talking about. Good. Right. Strings I'm going to be using are Diadro 8020 bronze, with a deep, bright and projecting tone. They're 11s to 52s, which are a custom light gauge. Basically, Fender's ones are 12s to 52s, but you can't buy that anywhere. For some reason there was a giant shortage. And so I bought these 11x52s and they seem absolutely fine. No problem with them whatsoever. So if they're good enough for the bigger one, they're good enough for this small one. So I'll put them aside. I can put my tools away now. It's always better to clean up as you go, isn't it? Nothing worse than just making more and more mess. Well, I'm going to set that on, have a look. There's just a slight bit of clearance in the middle, which will probably get slightly more with string tension. That suits me. I want the fret rocker just to have a feel. Few frets that rock, but honestly, I don't care. I'm not a finger picker. I'm quite a crude strummer. And that makes me happy, so that's what I do. But equally, it means that I'm not desperate for perfection here. So now I'm going to wipe off this extra oil, because I don't like having too much. Too much can cause it to swell and all sorts of problems. Huzzah, look at that. It's already looking 10 squillion times better. Very, very happy. So the next step is to put the strings back on, but I'm just going to let it sit there for a minute. And we will turn our attention to this case. Have a look at that. Again, just making sure to myself that we're still recording. Well, it does feel like there's only so much it can do. Just got one of these multi-white bags. And it's going to be perfect. With that, that's got a lot of the muck off. The inside looks good, it's got a nice padded bit. I'm just gonna check this. Oh, there's nothing in there, good. Hate to find something in there. So there's our case done. Let's string it up. Now, as always, when I come to string my guitars, I'm going to have to find it now. There we go. Use this handy guide, hopefully is in focus, to show you how to wind strings on. Very good guide, very useful. As always, make sure you pay attention to the colours. Last thing you want to do once you've come this far is put the strings on a weird way. Yep, yeah, we're still recording. It's more an amazement for me than anyone else. So I'm going to get all these lined up horizontal. And so it's time to put some of your strings on. It's always the fun bit, because it's the end bit. It's the bit that gets you closest to being able to play. So they always come in their pairs of two. I don't know why, I like to do high and low E first, and then I do all the rest in the middle. It's mainly for electric floating bridges, but it certainly doesn't hurt to do it with these. Just get them out. Some of these unravel beautifully, other ones really don't. The most important thing to do is to not kink them, because you're going to have a bad day, because they're not going to string properly. So. Nice and gentle with it all. There's no rush. This is meant to be your hobby. Take some time with it. And then off they ping. Okay, I'm just going to take a 5 second break. Right, so it's Eddie 8 Dynamite, goodbye Eddie. That's the way to remember it, isn't it? So the brass one is our thickest string. So this is where my bridge pin comes in. And what you want to do is, they've got this slot, you want to, basically it needs to sit just below the slot like that. So you feed the string down, you feed the bridge pin down, you pull it up, and you push down. There we go, we now have all the strings attached at the root of the guitar. Final thing to do is graphite them. Now you can buy special tools, special lubricant, special everything for guitar, but really it boils down to being able to polish it, oil it and lubricate it. So a graphite pencil does the job absolutely fine. You just put that on. And it stops it binding, so you should have a lot more stable tuning. Perfect. And then you can see where the strings touch. Just put a bit of graphite along them. Okay, now we're ready to string up. Okay, so I have put all the strings on and all the bridge pins are nice and tight, and I've just loosely got them all sitting up here on the end. Like so. And so now it's time to tune it, and I will spare you having to listen to lots of little twangs as I get it up to tune. Okay, here we go. Here is the final guitar. She is all beautifully polished. This mahogany finish is wonderful. Absolutely shines. And she sounds great. Just loving it. I'm absolutely loving it. Beautiful resonance. Beautiful feeling. It's going to be a great travel guitar to take places, honestly, and I'm very lucky to have it, and the case looks great as well. So there's just one last thing to show you, and there you go. It is the Fender Newporter next to the Fender Sonoran. A wonderful collection, if I do say so myself. Very, very happy. Okay, so thank you very much. That's the end of the video. We now have a wonderful guitar that I will cherish forever, and that sounds like an absolute dream. So the only final thing to do that I usually do in these videos is I play a little song at the end. So I'm still learning. I've only been playing for about 3/4 of a year now, so go easy on me. Skip this bit, but anyway, I thought the best one for this is Somewhere Over the Rainbow.